I am Dr. Geetha Sivaraman, M.u. College of Commerce, Pimpri, Pune. This college is affiliated to Savitri Bai Phule, Pune University. Now I would like to discuss about company law, which is the subject for SYBCOM. The topic I am going to discuss is lifting the corporate veil. Now, what is corporate personality? It means that the company's liabilities or the legal responsibility of the company, and the members will not be liable for the company's debts. Now, doctrine of the lifting of corporate veil. When a company registered under the Act, all the dealings of the company will be in the name of the company and the members will be disregarded. This shows that there is a veil between the company and its members. This veil is a partition or curtain between the company and its members. Following this principle, the court in most cases have refused to go behind the curtain. But sometimes the necessity of the situation may compel the authorities to disregard the corporate legal entity and look to individual members who are in fact the real beneficial owners of all corporate acts. The court will lift the veil in case for the public interest to secure justice. It must be kept in mind that a separate legal entity is still in the general rule. The corporate entity will be disregarded only in exceptional cases. The case may be judicial or it can be statutory. Judicial provisions for the benefit of revenue, if it has got enemy character, avoiding any legal obligations, if it is agency, breach of trust, for the public interest. Statutory provisions may be related to the reduction of number of members, fraudulent trading, misdescription of the company. So, one of the most attractive features of incorporating business entity is the limited liability protection accorded to its corporate directors, officers and shareholders. But when incorporating a business, a corporation will be viewed in the eyes of law as an entity entirely independent and distinct from its owners, the corporate shareholders. The concept of limited liability limits the risk of exposure of owners and shareholders to the conduct and actions of the corporation. The concept of incorporating a business rests behind the corporate veil, which entitles a company to function independently from its members. This protective veil should provide shield for owners and shareholders against personal liability from corporate debts. This means that in the most situations, creditors have no claim in the personal assets of an individual entrepreneurs when the corporation goes bankrupt. However, the corporate veil has its limitations. When corporate members fail to perform the responsibilities and neglect to maintain corporate formalities, the protective veil can be lifted through a process called piercing the corporate veil. It means that the individual corporate officials and owners can be held personally accountable for the debts, DEBTS, debts and obligations incurred by the corporation. Now, piercing the corporate veil, when does it happen? The court invokes the corporate will piercing when the corporate principals neglect to maintain the distinct characteristics between the corporation and the shareholders. In other words, they fail to correctly maintain the formality of the corporation. It is a judicial act that allows the creditor to lift the veil of limited liability protection conferred upon the corporate official owners. The court holds those people personally liable for corporate obligations. There are two theories behind the concept of piercing the corporate veil: the alter ego theory and the instrumentality theory. The alter ego or the self theory examines whether or not the owner managed the operation of the incorporated business as a separate legal entity. It scrutinizes, under the instrumentality theory, the court scrutinizes the corporation to see if it was used by its owners as a mere instrument for their own personal benefit. There are several factors that can most frequently lead to the corporate veil piercing. One is the failure of corporate members to exercise and maintain corporate formalities, such as conducting regular board of director and shareholder meetings, recording meetings minutes, and filing of proper corporate documents, as well as failure to adopt corporate bylaws and issuing shares at the time of corporation was formed. Another factor that may allow the court to ignore the separate legal entity characteristics is the failure to acquire and maintain adequate funding to sustain normal business operations, or undercapitalization after incorporation of business. Courts may disregard the corporate existence when the funds and the assets of a corporation are mingled with that corporate officers, directors, and shareholders. Neglecting to segregate corporate funds from personal assets of controlling shareholders, and the illegal diversion of corporate funds and assets are also the basis of corporate veil piercing. The primary goal is in applying the corporate doctrine of veil is to achieve the equitable result. Although applied in rare and exceptional circumstances, the outcome can be extremely harsh on those involved in this matter. Hence, it is important that separate legal entity status of the corporation and its owners are recognized and respected, thus maintaining limited liability protection granted to shareholders. Limited liability protection granted to shareholders by the incorporated business entity. So, lifting corporate veil, there is a veil between the company and the members, but it is lifted. There are exceptions. When there is the corporate veil is pierced and lifted, when there is tax evasion for the purpose of tax evasion, then for fraudulent activities are going on, misstatement is in the prospectus. So there are many reasons why the veil has to be pierced and see who is behind this veil, corporate veil, and justice, give justice to that effect. Thank you so much. Today we have completed lifting of corporate veil, and the next topic will be doctrine of constructive notice, doctrine of ultra vires, and doctrine of indoor management. these topics are slightly more difficult than other topics. So in the next speech, we will cover those topics. Thank you for giving opportunity. Thanks to SPPU for giving me an opportunity to speak on these topics. Thank you.